Hi and welcome. This is the second tutorial in which we learn how to run R in Python. Previously, we have learned to call R from Python and carrying out data analysis. In this Rpy2 tutorial, we will learn how to display plots in a Jupyter notebook. Of course, you will need to have Python and R installed, and of course, Rpy2, the package we use here. So Rpy2 can be installed using conda if you are a user of anaconda, the Python distribution. Just type conda install and so on. If you use pip, you can install it as well. So we are going to create plots using graphics and ggplot. Both of these two Rpy2 examples were inspired on answers on questions found on Stack Overflow. However, the second example is more adapted so that ggplot figures can be displayed in the Jupyter notebook. You will find links to these questions and the answers among other useful links in the description below. If you want to know how to install R packages from Python, see the previous video. Let's start coding. Okay, we are going to import three things from Rpy2. So R objects, because we want to import the R packages into Python using Rpy2. And then we are going to import gr devices to create an image of the plots that we are going to create here. So we are also going to import int vector just to create some integers for the bar plot function from the graphics package, which we will import. So let's start. Import Rpy2 R objects as R objects. And from rpy2.robjects.lib import gear devices, and from rpy2 r objects vectors import int vector, and finally from ipython.display import image and display, like that. So now we have hopefully typed everything correctly, so we can continue by importing the graphics library. R objects packages import R graphics. Yes. Okay. We continue by typing in more code to create the image. So with gear devices dot render to bytes io gear devices dot jpeg with 1024 height a 96 and the resolution 150 as image. And now we're going to create a plot. So we imported graphics, so we use graphics dot bar plot. And now we use int vector just to put in some integers. You can use your own data, of course. And this should be within a tuple, like that. And now we want a label on the y-axis. So ylab. Value And now we close it like that. Now we want to display this image, our plot, in this Jupyter Notebook. So format JPEG and embed true. Now let's see here. If we typed everything correctly, this should display a bar plot. And let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And this is the value. Continue with the next example in which we are going to use ggplot. So only to let you know, the Rpy2 was designed to use ggplot version 2.2.1. On my computer, I have 3.0.0 installed. It still works, but yeah, maybe it's better to use something else, like the graphics or the lattice package, or but I like ggplot 2. So import rpy2 robjects.lib ggplot2 as ggplot2. And now we also want to use some data sets that R comes with in this example. So data sets, R objects dot packages dot import R and data sets like that. And we are going to use the empty cars data set. So empty cars, R objects, packages, data, and data sets. And then we fetch empty cars. And we need to put in empty cars here as well. And we can print out the things here. Yeah, here you see. We get the user warning. It still works though. And here we have the data. Okay, now we have our data set. We are going to continue to just create a plot. And it's basically created in the same way, but using ggplot instead, of course. So we can cut and paste a similar line of code as from the previous example. The only thing I've changed here is PNG here, just to show that it's possible. And GP, ggplot, 2, ggplot, empty cars. Now, ggplot 2 comes with a lot of nice methods, functions to get the plots to look nice. So we are going to continue here with creating a new variable pp, we do like this. Start by gp, and then we have plus ggplot2 dot ie has string. So x is wt, y is mpg. We continue ggplot2 to create some points on the plot. So we use geom point. ggplot2 as string color equals to qsec. So we're going to use a color a scale gradient, so the dots will have a slightly different color based on the qsec value they have. Scale color gradient, low, yellow, and high, red. So we can continue now by having a title and for the plot and for the x and y axes. Ggplot labs title Rpy2 ggplot. Ggplot 2 empty cars. And I like to have my plots in black and white. So, like that, MPP plot. And then the same as the previous example, display image, only thing, the format is PNG now. So, ggplot is not defined. No, of course not. So, here we have our scatter plot. You can see the range from yellow to red. So you see here we have a grid, and I don't really like the grid and the type of journals I have experience of. Don't like grids either. So we can use ggplot theme, ggplot to theme. And now we have to input a dictionary. So panel grid major is the key. And here we're going to just cut and paste a value, ggplot2 element blank. And same goes for the panel grid minor. And let's see how this changes our plot. Yeah, see, no grids now. So now you know how to display plots, R plots to be more specific in Jupyter Notebooks. So we have run R in Python to create plots using graphics and Ggplot2, and we have displayed them within the Jupyter Notebook. I hope you learned something, and if you do, please make sure to hit that thumbs up button and subscribe to the channel if you haven't. And until next time, bye.